Today we are going to see about the contract costing. First we are going to see about the definition. As per the official CIMA terminology, contract costing is a form of specific order costing in which costs are attributed to individual contract. Now we are going to see about the problem. Senthil Construction Company undertook a contract for constructing and building from 1st Jan 2010. Contract price was rupees 1 lakh. He incurred the following expenses: material issue rupees 6000, material in hand at the end rupees 1000, wages rupees 5000, direct expenses rupees 20000, plant purchase rupees 10000. The contract was completed on 30th June 2010 and the contract price was duly received. Provide depreciation at 20% per annum on plant and charge. Indirect expenses at 20% on wages. Prepare a contract account. Now we are going to prepare a contract account. Two material issues, rupees 6000, to wages 5000, to direct expenses 20000. Now to depreciation. Depreciation on plant 10,000 and 20% of depreciation into now the contract was completed on 30th June but 2010 and the contract started on 1st 2010 and the contract started on 1st Jan 2010. So 6 months. So 6 by 12. When we calculate this, we get 1000 on depreciation. Next, we are going to put two indirect expenses. Indirect expenses on 20% on wages. So we get 1000. Then credit side, buy material on and material in hand, sorry, 1000. Then buy contract price is 1 lakh. Totally we get 1000, 1 lakh and 1000. 1 lakh and 1000. So to profit we get 68,000 is a profit. This is a small step which we calculate in contract accounting. Next problem we are going to see about the incomplete contract. Pari and about the incomplete contract. Pari and Co. obtained a contract for building a factory for rupees 10 lakh. Building operation started on 1st April 1984 and at the end of March 1985 they received from the contractee and sum of rupees 3,90,000 being 75% of the amount due on surveyor certificate. The following additional information is given from the books of Paris and Co. Limited. Store issued to contract rupees 2 lakh. Store on contract on 30th 3 1985 rupees 10,000. Wages paid rupees 80,000. Plant purchase rupees 2 lakh. Direct expenses rupees 25,000. Overheads allocated to contract rupees 1,000. Work finished but not yet certified, ₹12,000. Plan to be depreciated at 10%. You are required to prepare an account showing profit and loss on contract as on 31st 3 85, and amount of profit on the company could be justified in taking to the credit of profit and loss account for the year. So we are going to prepare a incomplete contract account now. So incomplete contract account, pari and co contract account for the year ending 31st March 1985. As usual, we have to put the format: particular rupees, debtors, creditors, debit side and credit side. Okay. Now we are going to prepare a pari and co contract account. First, to material in debit side, to material issued is ₹2 lakh. Okay, then to wages is 1,80,000. To plant is 2 lakh. Then to direct expenses is 25,000. Then to overheads is 12,000. Now the credit side. First we have to put the plant depreciation. So by plant is 12,000. Now the credit side. First we have to put the plant depreciation. So by plant is 2 lakh. Then less depreciation. So the depreciation is 10%. So we get 20,000. When we less it, we get 1,80,000. Now work certified is 3,90,000. We have work satisfied. So 3,90,000 into 100/75. In contract account, we should put 100/75. So we get 5,20,000. Then by store in hand and material in hand are same. So we get 10,000. Then by work uncertified is 12,000. We have work unsatisfied is 12,000. So 12 work unsatisfied is 12,000. So 12,000. Now we should put the total. 1,80,000, 5,20,000, 10,000 and 12,000, we get 7,22,000. Here also we get 7,20,000. We get the notional profit is 1,05,000. It is the notional profit. Is a balancing figure. Okay, next we have to prepare a transfer of profit to find a reserve. To prepare a transfer of profit, the transfer of profit means we get the notional profit 1,05,000, no, that we should transfer here on credit side by notional profit carry forward 1,05,000. Okay, then we have to put a working note. So working note, first we have a percentage of work certified on contract price. Of work certified on contract price is equal to work certified by contract price into 100. What is the work certified amount? 5,20,000 by 10,00,000 contract price. Work certified one 5,20,000, contract price one 10,00,000 into 100. So we get 52%. Above 52% means the profit to be credited to P&L account, notional profit into 2 by 3 into cash received by work certified. If we get below 50%, we should put notional profit into 1 by 3 into cash received by work certified. If we get below 25, there is no loss and no profit. So we get 52% is above 50%. So the notional profit is 1,05,000 into 2 by 3 into cash received amount. What is the cash received amount here? 3,90,000 is a cash reserved. So 3,90,000 by work satisfied is 5,20,000. So we multiply this, we get 72 by 3, we get 70,000 into this 6.75. You multiply this, we get 52,500. It is a profit to be credited to P&L account. Profit to be kept in reserve. Formula is notional profit less profit to be credited. Notional profit we get is 1,05,000 is a notional profit. Less profit to be credited is 52,500. So we get reserve as rupees 52,500 is the reserve. Okay. Now we are going to put the transfer of profit. Already we transfer the notional profit of 1,05,000. Now in debit side to work in progress is a reserve. Okay, so the reserve amount which we get is 52,500. So we should put 52,500. Next to profit and loss account, we get again profit to be credited. What we get? 52,500, same amount. So 52,500, the total we get is 1,05,000. Here also the same total 1,05,000, it should be tallied. So it is a transfer of profit in contract account. Incomplete contract account means we should put like this. Thank you, viewers.